big game owl.
Hello everyone, big game owl here, Planet Retro. Pickups video, episode 18. And there's not much to show you this week. Because I'm not trying to use all my stock that I got in one go. We'll get onto that in a bit. But I want to start this week with my biggest and most expensive pickup. Really, really happy to get this. It's got a little bit of damage on it. This is unreal. It's got a little bit of a tear there, but other than that, it's in really good condition. So I was really, really happy to find that. I'm only joking. I got that about a month ago, when everyone stopped staring at people. Everyone weren't staring at people back then. Because I've actually been stuck indoors since last Tuesday. Haven't been able to get out, so the stuff I've got here I had before last Tuesday, what was just piled up. But I've got a couple of bits saved. I've got a couple of bits coming from CEX, which I was lucky enough to order the other day. Because if you don't know, as of today, all CEX are shut. So you won't be able to buy anything online or in the shops. As far as I know, anyway. As well as the Facebook groups. A lot of the Facebook groups, the admins have said, no more sales. Due to infectious diseases being spread here, there and everywhere. Because you don't know who's got what. So yep, CEX have shut. All of the retailers were shut now as well. After Boris told them all to close last night. So all your games, what else you got out there? Cash converters, CEX, all going to be shut. So I don't know where we're going to get our games from. I think eBay's still going at the moment. Although I've heard rumours from people, sent me pictures of sellers saying they're not going to send that. Which I hope don't happen, because I'm bidding on a lot of games that finished today. So I'm bidding on 19 NES games at the moment. So by the time this video goes up later, you'll be able to ask me whether I won them or not, because they're all going to be ended before this finishes, before this goes live, should I say. And looking from it, as no one's listening to Boris, I think it's going to be total lockdown enforced by Thursday. Because they are pushing the new law through, and it can't go through till Thursday at the earliest. So I think Thursday evening, prepare yourself, because no one's going to listen to Boris as usual. And there will be fines enforced. Probably be like Italy, only allowed to go supermarket, one member of your family, one at a time, once a week. So let's hope that don't happen. But I really hope Royal Mail is still delivering us. I've got my parcels today, so they're still working at the moment. Just like to give a thank you to all the new subs. All the new subs that are watching me. And Darren. Darren from Half Hour Gamers. He gave me a shout out in, not his last video, the one before that. Because he's like me, he must be bored at home getting all these videos out one after the other. But, right. So, as always, I'd like to start with a beer. As no one else can do anything else these days, so we just sit indoors and get drunk now. We have got the Golden IPA. Golden IPA, Brooklyn and Defender. 5.5%. Looks alright. I'll give that a go, but before that I just want to change my light on my camera. Because I always forget to do this. Sorry about that, not the end button while I'm trying to do it. So as I was saying, Brooklyn IPA. smells strong. Nice thick head, well and truly golden. No fruity smell on this one, just hops. Can really smell the barley on this one. Doesn't say too much on the can about it. In fact, it says nothing on the can about it. Other than it says it's a beer, and it's right underneath it says golden IPA, so which is it? Got a strong aftertaste to it. Really full-bodied hoppy aftertaste. I like that, but I don't think you can drink too many of them. Don't waste anything. Hard times. So again, that's Brooklyn and Defender IPA. Right, first of all, just want to mention a couple of fouls. First one, don't know what I'm meant to do with these. Ordered this online, and it's turned up, no manual in it. So this is going back eventually. I'm assuming they're just going to extend their 2 weeks to from when the shop shuts to when the shop opens. But that'll be going back, which is quite gutting because I wanted to play. Well, I can play it, I suppose, and then take it back. Might do that. And secondly, one I can't play, but I've agreed a deal to sell this to someone. And this Pinball Quest. I actually ordered Pinball, which is meant to be a black label game, one of the original NES games. But if you can't tell from this one, it's American, NTSC. So I've just agreed to sell that on for the price that I paid. Alright, so let's look at some stuff first. So as you know, these were a couple of weeks ago, at least before I picked these up. So first is WDL, World Destruction League, Thunder Tanks. It was only 50p. Looked pretty basic, but it looked quite fun, my sort of game. Just driving around in a tank, blowing things up by the looks of it. Multiplayer's available. And lovely and complete. Disc is a bit dirty, but no scratches on it. Always keep forgetting to check these discs. A nice thick manual. So now we've got plenty of time off now. Drop down in the comments what games you're actually going to be playing. Because there's a series that I will be playing. And managed to pick up the third one in the series. And this game actually cost me nothing. Thinking, how's that free? I got it off eBay. And I traded in my Nectar points. I had £10 worth of Nectar points. Dad this up for £10 plus £2 delivery, offered them £8, they accepted. So for free, we got Sly 3. Which is part of the Sly Raccoon series, this is the third one. And they're fun little games you play as like a thief. You play as Sly. And I'm assuming this is meant to be 3D because it's got some 3D glasses in there as well. And they are for this game, they've got Sly 3 on them. So I don't know if there's like a 3D movie involved or something, or like a cartoon, or whether there's parts in the game you need to be in 3D. But it's all nice and complete, so really happy with that. It's just the box is a little bit scratched. And another CEX purchase. I actually picked this up the same time as the same day, it weren't the same shop, but it was the same day I picked up the Paper Mario. And again, I looked at this, and if this one was in good condition, which it was, I was gonna buy it. And it's a series that I know Rob likes. Gernaldinho plays. And that's F-Zero. GX. So it's like a racing style game. It's a bit like Wipeout. Not played any of the F-Zero games. This is the very first one that I've picked up. Not tried it yet. Again, I didn't check the disc at the time, which I should have done. That's perfect. Not a scratch on it. Let me know if you played this. What you think of it? Like I say, it looks just like a racing type game by the looks of the screenshots on the back, like multiplayer modes. Another one for the GameCube collection. Another one ticked off the list. Right. As you know, everyone's sitting indoors bored. And you're probably bored of me by now, because if you haven't noticed, I've been uploading content daily at the moment. And it's not going to be daily anymore. Last night's video was a bit... just sitting here, I thought, oh, I'm going to try them things, I'll make a video of it. And the thumbnail, I hope that hasn't offended anyone. I spoke to Stu beforehand. Made sure that it was alright for me to use the thumbnail for it. And he laughed at it when I showed him it, so he was happy. But the reason the liar part is on it is because at Milton Keynes he told me it was to play imports. And then a couple of days later he said he tried it and he didn't play the imports, so... that's the liar part. But if you haven't seen that video, go and watch it. There's some great shooters on there, all Japanese, and I was really grateful for them. And I haven't managed to try another PS2, Stu, to make sure that they all work, but I've got a feeling it was my PlayStation. And then everyone's moaning about my controllers. How comes it works fine on some games and then on a couple it didn't? So I don't know, I have to try it. I've got a few controllers. I've got about 3 or 4 PS2s, so I'll give them a try on another console and see what happens. Might just be my one was a bit playing out and maybe it's coming to an end. But for upcoming content, I've been doing the Gran Turismo series, which I'm hoping to get out roughly around a 30-minute video every Saturday. I've filmed 3 episodes so far and I'm hoping to do a couple more after this. I don't know what the objective of the season is yet. I'm just trying to build my coins up at the moment because it's been pretty tricky getting them. So yeah, I think probably own one of every car and get all the licenses, compete in every race. I don't know. Let me know suggestions of what you want that series to go like. Or if you're bored of that one, let me know what other games you'd rather me play. I mean, I probably should have chose Gran Turismo 2, because there was a lot more on that one, but... the first one was the one that I got originally with my PS1, so... I thought I'd go back to playing that one. Also, I don't really fancy doing, like, 3 months worth of videos just me doing the 24-hour endurance race. So yeah, What else we got? I've been doing collection videos. Finally got round to sorting out my collection videos and filming them. Done a couple so far. I've done only on Xbox and PSP. Going to be doing the Wii, N64. What else will I do? Probably do the PS3 and 4. Just trying to figure out the ones what are not going to be that long to do, because I think if I start doing like the PlayStation 2 and the GameCube and the NES, they're going to end up going into like three or four parts. And I try and keep it in one, but with them ones I'm going to have to do more than one. But I think I might do the PS1 double case. I'm just looking in front of me now, what's there. Probably do a joint one with the SNES. What have I got? The SNES. My handheld games for the Game Boy and stuff. And probably the Switch, because I haven't got enough to do one of each of them. So I'll probably do a joint one with them three. Just to show you what I've got. And you never know. I might get round to doing the NES. Might give it a go. PS1 maybe. Got quite a few PS1 games. We'll just see what happens. But other than that, I don't really know what else I'm going to be putting out, because as long as eBay keeps going, I suppose I can keep putting out pickups videos. But if eBay stops and this goes on for as long as people are saying, I don't know. Might have to call the Tuesday videos to an end, or at least not do pickups videos for them. Might just be me sitting here chatting to you for half an hour, not showing anything. I have to do a few beer reviews. I've got a few different types of beers stocked up. I'll probably only do like four in each episode though, just so I don't run out. And also I've been going into Kieran's Game Boys Are Awesome's live streams. I was on there the other night for about 5 hours. We had Eddie Rollercore join us. Stu was in there chatting. He didn't come on the video, he's just chatting. Kevin Wolford, 123. Then like Cole, the Nameless Gamer, Alex all come and chatted in the chat. So if he does do any live streams, make sure you sub to him and go and watch him, because I'm sure he'll be doing probably one a night or every other night now. Great channel. Love watching his car boot videos. So yeah. What was there to talk about? Trying to drag this video out a bit. Give you something to watch. Right, so I went to Game again. 4 for £20. And the first game, the guy was like, "Are you sure you want that one?" He was trying to get me to put it back. Now, I don't know if this game is meant to be as bad as he says, or if you can even play it, because he reckons the servers might be down for it, so I've not tried it yet. It requires the internet, and that's Metal Gear Survive, which is meant to be like a Fortnite style game for Metal Gear. I thought it was part of Metal Gear Solid, but it's not by the looks of it. Might be, it might just be the people from Metal Gear Solid trying to make some extra money, but I'll see if I could play it anyway. Could be a laugh. But at least I got it in the collection, especially if it is one of these ones that are going to be tricky to find because you can't play them anymore. And for a fiver, PS4 game, you can't really go wrong. Right, next up is a game that the Nameless Gamer will be interesting to look at. He might already have it for a while now. And that's Trials Fusion. It's a motorbike game. do all stunts and tricks by the looks of it. And the only problem with this one is the disc. The guy has put a American disc in it. Which at least for the PS4 is region free, so at least I can still play it. It looks alright. It's supposed to be the deluxe edition, but it's not going to be a deluxe edition. It was the same price as the normal ones. I picked this one up just in case, but there's no codes in there or anything. It doesn't say deluxe edition on the disc because they give me an American one, so it's not going to be. But could be a bit of a laugh. I would say invite people over to play it, 1 to 4 player, but you're not allowed. Right, next up, we've got Dragon's Quest Heroes. I don't mind the Dragon Quest games. I've got the PS2 one. The King's Bounty or something, what it's called. The world trees woes. Woe and the bright below. The world trees woe and the bright below. Blight below. What the hell is the blight below? Includes 5 bonus slime weapons. It's a day one edition. Probably means nothing now. But it looks alright. I'll give it a little play, see what it's like. We've got nothing else to do these days, have we? And next up, Rhyme. Don't know much about this. It looks a bit like Ico, whatever you want to call it, for the PS2. I mean, it looks alright, but it was the most expensive game to buy if you was buying it from CEX, so I added it to the bundle. Because I think I could, if I don't like it, I think I can get £6 for it, I'm sure. But there you go, another 4 for £20. Not bad. These ones have got white spines on them. I like the picture ones for the PS4. Two items left. Then I want to give a couple of shout outs to a couple of people. A couple of people I've already shouted out on this channel, and one I've just been watching because I love their content. Right. So as you know, PS1 double cases, the race is on. You got me, Eddie, you started it, the subset collector, the centretter, trendsetter as everyone calls him, Mr. Subset. So for the PS1 double case, as you know, Eddie, Tootie, Boofy ALX 200, and our Super Quintendo. Craig has thrown his hat in the ring, said he's going to start collecting them as well. But this is one I've been winding Eddie up with for a little while, because it's another one he needs. That's Destruction Derby. Now this one, I don't know, this one's a bit strange. Because you've got the disc and the manual there. English, German and French. But in the back, you've got a demo disc that don't stay in. Because there's no teeth marks in there, I don't know if that's meant to be like that. Don't even know if this is meant to be for this game. But it was in there. And you got another manual with Spanish, Italian and Dutch. But I'm also happy that I got this because Rob Gernardino plays. First time in 10 years. As you can see, I've just picked this up. I haven't owned this for 10 years. Well over 10 years. Has done his first time in 10 years challenges, so I can do another one of them. That'll be another one ticked off the list. I'm also planning on doing 4 or 5 other ones as well. So there'll be a few of these coming out as well, just to pass the time. Like I say, plenty of content on this channel. Last up, got a NES game off of eBay, which I'm hoping is going to be the first of many to be shown on this channel over the coming weeks. And this one is Solomon's Key. I have no idea what it's about. I think it's a bit like Solstice by the looks of it. Look, it's in mint condition. Really, really nice mint condition. And it's another one ticked off the list. Solomon's Key. Another one ticked off the list. Alright. And that's it for what I've got this week. I can't show you too much. Just want to thank everyone that's been watching all my videos and leaving comments and just... I don't even mind if you leave the comment, lovely, I enjoy replying to them, but if you watch it, I'm just grateful that you're watching it. I mean, I'm the same, I might watch a video and I might not leave a comment for, well, I might not ever leave a comment, or I might take me 3 or 4 days because I watch it on TV. So unless I get my phone or I've got my phone handy and I can jump on and leave a comment. Not really much I could do unless I remember, but I've been watching the TBN, is it TMB, the podcast that Russ the Retro Bear's putting out, and I've really been enjoying that, and I've heard he's going to be doing them weekly now. I think they're coming out every Sunday. He's going to try and get a set time and date every week. I'm sure he said Sunday at 7 p.m. So I'm going to think of some topics and send them to him. Hopefully he reads them out on the thing. Also this week I've been so bored, as you could tell from my last video. Shaved all my beard off. Give myself my own haircut. I think I've done a pretty good job. Found me while I was tidying up my room, because I've got nothing else to do this week. While I was tidying up under my bed, I found my old hair trimmers. So I'll give them a go. I don't know if barbers are open. Are they classed as an essential thing? Because you'll be touching people's heads all the time, which you're not meant to do. But yeah. So my shoutouts for this week. First one. The guy that's been shouted out on this channel and mentioned a lot of times. But I don't feel he's getting the subs, because he started about a week before me, but I think he's about 20 subs less than me at the moment. And that's Cole's Room 70. And I know he's going to have a lot of content coming out now, because he's going to be off work. So make sure you head over to his channel and check out all his stuff. I guess we'll all be doing gameplays from now on, because we ain't really, we can have like 2 or 3 weeks of pickups, but then after that, where are we going to get them from? So I know he's got a few ideas up his hand. He's going to be doing a few of Gernardino's challenges. I've actually just sent him a copy of a game for one of them, because he didn't have one. And I have accidentally purchased 2 copies of it. So I sent one to him. There's only a couple of quid off eBay. Put a bid in it, forgot about it, and bought it at London Gaming Market. So he'll be doing that video soon. Also, Russ, the Retro Bear, just want to let you know that your parcel's on its way as well. Should be getting that shortly. So go and check out Cole, Cole's Room 70. All of these channels, I'll put the links down below. Next one, Hyper Trigger X, Dylan. He's, as currently as recording this, he's got 96 subs. So let's push him over 100 today. If you like your Xbox 360 or your shooters, he does a lot of Japanese stuff. Mr. Limited Run, always sending us stuff in the group chat of, oh, check out this game is coming out. But really nice guy, very knowledgeable. Help you with anything. You ask him any questions, he'll find out for you if he don't know himself. So go and drop him a sub. Let's get him over 100. Hyper Trigger X. And the last one I want to shout out is nothing to do with our community. He's an American YouTuber. Does a lot of thrifting videos. He goes to the bins, as they call it over there. Where they just bring out a big trolley and everyone just dives in it and sees what they pull out. And he's massively into game collecting, toy collecting. He does loads of stuff. And he uploads daily. There's him, his missus, and their flatmate. They live with their housemate they live with. The three of them. And he's Tendo. Used to be Shark Tendo, but now he's just called himself Tendo. And like I say, he does daily content. He's been keeping me entertained every day for the last, like, 6 months. I think I've been watching him now. So if you haven't checked him out, I recommend you go and have a look. And it's not going to be for everyone. But I'm sure a few of my viewers here will enjoy watching him. So his name's Dallas. His missus is Hannah, and they live with a guy called Patrick, they used to go to college together or something. They all share a little house together. But yeah, he's opened up some toy booths and some game shops. And he goes around looking for stuff and sourcing it from, like, Goodwills and, like he says, the bins, whatever that is. Just all sorts of different American shops. It's great fun to watch, and it's very entertaining. Some of the stupid stuff they do is brilliant. But yeah, if you do want to go check out any of them channels, I hope you do. And if you do, just let them know that I sent you over there. Tell them Planet Retro sent you. Don't say Big Game Al sent you to Tendo, because he won't have a clue. But he does live streams, and I do chat in his live streams, so I'm sure if you say Planet Retro sent you, they probably know who I am. But yeah, that's everything I've got to show you this week. Now, if the Royal Mail stop for posting now, I've got 5 games to show you next Tuesday, so let's hope we can get a few more in. But as always, see you next Tuesday. I give you my heart.